Good morning, students. Here we come up with the embryology lecture of development of primitive streak. Basically, this is the changes in the third week of pregnancy period. So, therefore, third week of pregnancy period, we start always with primitive streak. And this primitive streak is often asked as a short note. Write a short note on development of primitive streak, or it is also, it can be asked in this way also. Write a short note on development of gastrulation, or simply gastrulation. Both are one and the same. And this primitive streak or gastrulation is the starting of changes in the third week of pregnancy period. So changes in the third week, we always start with this development of primitive streak, and oblique, that will be gastrulation. So therefore, here we start with the changes in the embryonic disc. Up till now, up till the end of second week, there was development of bilaminar germ disc, which we have seen. Now, during this stage, the changes in the germ disc will be, this is the first point in the development of primitive streak. This is the first point. Initially, we go according to the line diagram. At the end of second week, the germ disc is circular. Remember, we are concentrating only on the germ disc. So at the end of second week, the entire bilaminar germ disc with epiblast above and hypoblast is circular. With, there will be formation of, this also we have seen, pre-caudal plate at the cephalic end. And at the caudal end, it will be connected or joined by connecting stalk. So this is the connecting stalk at the caudal end of germ disc by a portion of extra-embryonic mesoderm. Remember, this is a transverse diagram, transverse section. We are looking at the germ disc only from the above after the removal of amniotic cavity. So from the above, we are looking at the germ disc only, transverse section. And caudal end, we know that there is extra-embryonic mesoderm, and it is a portion of connecting stalk which is attaching it to the outer trophoblast. So therefore, now the germ disc is circular. Immediately, it will change its shape. This germ disc, it will change its shape, and it will become, if I come on this side, it will become oval. Now this germ disc will become oval in shape. Please draw this next diagram, and we will show here again there will be at the tail end, it will be connected with connecting stalk. So this portion will be represented as the entire connecting stalk. Now from circular, this was circular germ disc, now it has become oval in shape with a broad cephalic end and narrow caudal end. This point is very important. So now the germ disc has become oval in shape with a broad cephalic end and narrow caudal end. And in the cephalic part, we will show here pre-caudal plate. Now, very interesting, very important change will take place at this phase. There will be complete differentiation of the epiblast layer. The ectodermal layer, which is present, that is the primary ectoderm, epiblast layer, that will differentiate into three different zones, three different ectoderms. Please note down. The first ectoderm will be entire cephalic end and the two lateral ends of the germ disc. It will differentiate into surface ectoderm. So we are going to draw that. Before we draw the surface ectoderm, I would like that here you draw a small oblong shaped area and leave it as it is. Now we will use the color, we will use red color, not red, but we'll use orange color for the entire surface ectoderm. So here I'm drawing this with orange color, and this orange color, it is covering the cephalic end as well as it is covering the two margins of the disc, right and left. Now this is the margins of the disc, right and left. So this portion up till here, this entire portion which I have colored is known as surface ectoderm. So therefore, now the first ectodermal layer to differentiate will be surface ectoderm. Remember the changes and the differentiation which is taking place from the epiblast layer itself. So from the epiplast layer, the ectoderm will differentiate into three different zones, three different ectodermal layers. The first will be surface ectoderm, which will cover the syphilic end of the embryo as well as the two lateral margins of the entire embryo. Lateral margins of the disc, remember, lateral margins of the disc. So therefore, that covering ectoderm now is called surface ectoderm. And what will it develop into? Here I am going to write down. It will develop into, please see that this portion will come. So it will develop into the epidermis of the skin. Note down. This is very important. So the entire surface ectoderm will develop into the epidermis of the skin of the embryo. Very important. After this, now second, the second layer that will be developed will be neuroectoderm. Please note down. And this neuroectoderm will be in this area which we have drawn. So therefore, that neuroectoderm, we will use the color as, let me use yellow color. A narrow strip of ectoderm in the central plane, just above the epiblast, just above the primary ectoderm. That narrow strip of ectoderm will differentiate into the neuroectoderm. So this neuroectoderm I am filling with yellow color, and this entire strip will be known as neuroectoderm. So here I am going to highlight this. I have drawn this with different color. I am highlighting it, and we are going to name this as neuroectoderm. So this is the neuroectoderm which I have written here. So for now, here this is the neuroectoderm. It will develop into, this entire strip of neuroectoderm will develop into central nervous system. So central nervous system, we know that brain and spinal cord will develop from neuroectoderm. It is also called neural plate or medullary plate, other names. So the other name of this will be neural plate / medullary plate. This is the second layer of ectoderm which is differentiated. Now the third layer, very important, the third layer of the ectoderm which is differentiated at this time, at this point, when the disc has become oval in shape, will be, there will be at the caudal end here, where the space is there, where my hand is there, at the caudal end of the entire germ disc, this is the germ disc. At the caudal end of entire germ disc, there will be collection of pluripotent ectodermal cells. The pluripotent ectodermal cells, that is from the epiblast layer, will invaginate, and it will form a linear opacity. So therefore, that linear opacity I will draw with pink color. Here I will show that linear opacity I am showing in this way. So this is the opacity. So therefore, pluripotent, please note down, pluripotent ectodermal cells, they are forming a linear opacity where in the caudal part, which will be known as primitive streak. So therefore, here, this is the third ectodermal layer to differentiate. Note down, it is known as primitive streak, S-T-R-E-A-K, but here what you have to write down is, at this phase of growth, there will be invagination of, write down, pluripotent ectodermal stem cells. This is very important. So the pluripotent ectodermal cells from the epiblast layer only, they will form a linear opacity at this stage, which will be known as primitive streak. So here, once these three layers are developed, it will change its shape. Since it was oval, now it becomes pear shape. The entire germ disc will become pear shape, and there will be further differentiation of primitive streak. Now please note down, all these changes are taking place on 18th day after fertilization. So therefore, 18th day, after fertilization, the entire germ disc is changing its shape, and on the 18th day it is called, and now the further differentiation will be of primitive streak. So up till now we have understood very simple it is, the three germ layers, surface ectoderm, neuroectoderm and primitive streak. Now what will happen to the primitive streak? The whatever now further changes are going to take place will be from primitive streak, because surface ectoderm will slowly develop into epidermis of the skin of the embryo. Neuroectoderm here will slowly develop and differentiate after some time into the entire central nervous system. Now it is time for the primitive streak to further differentiate and start its action. So therefore now what we are going to do is, we are going to, I will draw on this side only, here I am going to draw so that we can compare the two diagrams. At this site I am going to draw, here I will draw this primitive streak. Now the shape of primitive streak will become, please note down, the shape of primitive streak will become pear shaped. From oval it is going to become pear shaped germ disc. This was oval, this will become pear shaped. So the entire germ disc changes its shape into pear shaped, and now what we will show it will be here. Of course there is pre-caudal plate, we leave it like as it is, and here in the center we are going to show this oblong shaped neural plate, and then we are going to give different colors. For example, here we are going to show the surface ectoderm. Please draw the surface ectoderm, same surface ectoderm here. This is what we are drawing, surface ectoderm. And we know that this surface ectoderm will develop into the epidermis of the skin. After drawing this surface ectoderm, what we do is we need to draw this neural tube. So therefore, that is neuroectoderm. Now this neuroectoderm will differentiate into neural tube, that is central nervous system. So therefore, here in the last, we are going to draw, please note down, we are going to draw this primitive streak in this manner. Please draw it. This is how we have to draw the primitive streak, and we are going to show that it will have thick lateral borders in this way. And now we are going to write down about primitive streak. So therefore, after noting down, after drawing this much, this primitive streak, here we are going to write down primitive streak. And of course, this portion is nothing but neuroectoderm, and of course, this portion is surface ectoderm. So now, the disc has become pear-shaped. Primitive streak was already developed when the disc was oval in shape. It was a linear opacity. Now further changes. This primitive streak on 15th day, remember on 15th day, if MCQ is asked what on what the primitive streak will develop, 15th day is not down. So primitive streak will start its development, or it will appear on 15th day of the embryonic developmental stage. So on the 15th day, primitive streak will appear, and this primitive streak will now change its shape in such a way that it will be a linear, centrally depressed portion with slightly raised lateral margins. This is an important sentence. Now the primitive streak becomes a linear, depressed portion. Centrally it is linear and depressed, and laterally it will have the laterally slightly elevated margins. So laterally elevated margins and centrally depressed portion, that becomes the shape of the primitive streak. This sentence has to be noted down. Now after this, what will happen is, therefore, another important sentence, this entire primitive streak will be formed by migration as well as invagination. These two are very important. Migration as well as invagination of the pluripotent ectodermal cells. And pluripotent ectodermal cells, that means they are a part of stem cells only. basically there are two types of stem cells. We know that totipotent and pluripotent stem cells. Now here, this pluripotent stem cells, they are migrating from the epiblast layer, we know that. So at this point, the primitive streak consists of pluripotent ectodermal cells which are migrating and which are invaginating. Which are migrating and which are invaginating. What? They will migrate and invaginate in between the two layers of the bilaminar germ disc. What are the two layers of bilaminar germ disc? Upper epiblast and lower hypoblast. Epiblast is called primary ectoderm and hypoblast is called primary endoderm. So please note down. Therefore, this primitive streak consists of, I am writing down in short format, it consists of migration and invagination. Migration and invagination of what? Of pluripotent ectodermal cells. Please note down. Pluripotent ectodermal cells. Where will this migration and invagination take place? In between the, so write down, in between the epiblast and hypoblast layers. Do not complicate, it is very simple. So in between primary ectoderm and primary endoderm, that is epiblast and hypoblast, this migration and invagination of cells of primitive streak will take place. And what are the cells of primitive streak? They are pluripotent ectodermal cells. Finish. So we know, right now we know what is the shape now. The primitive streak consists of centrally linear depressed portion and slightly elevated lateral margins. And what it consists of? It consists of pluripotent stem cells which are migrating. Now they are migrating and invaginating in between the epiblast and hypoblast. So therefore, this entire process, whatever we have written, migration and invagination of pluripotent ectodermal cells from primitive streak in between the epiblast and hypoblast layers. This entire process is called gastrulation. So please note down, here I am writing with big words. This entire process is called gastrulation. Sometimes you are asked, write a short note on gastrulation. What is gastrulation? This is gastrulation. Therefore, here we know that in gastrulation, the entire process of the migration and invagination of pluripotent ectodermal cells, primitive streak, from the primitive streak, in between the primary ectoderm and primary endoderm, is the process which is known as gastrulation. Now, what are the changes that will take place in gastrulation? The changes that is going to take place in gastrulation, very important, slowly, all the three changes. The first change that is going to take place will be the entire, this migrating and invaginating pluripotent ectodermal cells of primitive streak will first replace the entire primary endoderm. So as they replace the primary endoderm, please note down this change, write it as primary endoderm. They are going to replace the primary endoderm as definitive endoderm. So the first jump layer is developed. So therefore, these cells of primitive streak, in the process of gastrulation, they are replacing the entire cells of primary endoderm with definitive endoderm. Second important change. Now, they are going to pass in between, everywhere, even laterally also, they are going to pass everywhere, but in between, which is the layer which is lying above? Above layer is epiblast. Epiblast is also called primary ectoderm. Still, primary ectoderm. And in between primary ectoderm and definitive endoderm. Please note down this important second change. So now, the remaining cells of the pluripotent ectodermal cells of the primitive streak during the process of gastrulation, after they have replaced primary endoderm with definitive endoderm, now they are passing in between the two layers. Upper layer primary ectoderm and lower layer definitive endoderm. That is what I have written, epiblast or primary ectoderm and definitive endoderm, that is the layer which is developed. So in between these two layers, it is going to form the second germ layer. Please note down, intra-embryonic mesoderm. So this is the development of the second germ layer, intraembryonic mesoderm. Now the third and the last differentiation, or the third and the last change, which layer is left now? Epiblast. And what is that epiblast known as? Primary ectoderm. So therefore, the remaining cells of pluripotent ectodermal cells from primitive streak, that means the remaining cells of primitive streak, they are going to replace the primary ectoderm layer, the entire epiblast layer, the primary ectoderm layer, into definitive ectoderm. This is the third germ layer. And therefore, the gastrulation process is complete. So at the end of gastrulation, what we are having? All the three germ layers, definitive ectoderm, intraembryonic mesoderm, and definitive endoderm. So if we go from this side, definitive endoderm, intraembryonic mesoderm, definitive ectoderm. Once again, I repeat, definitive endoderm, intraembryonic mesoderm, and definitive ectoderm. All the three germ layers, final germ layers, are established, they are differentiated, they have developed as a result of gastrulation. And now the important sentence comes, please note down. Many a times this is asked in one mark question answer in MCQs. All the three germ layers, definitive endoderm, the intraembryonic mesoderm, and definitive ectoderm, are developed from which cells? They are developed from pluripotent cells of primitive streak. And where are these cells coming from? These cells are coming from epiblast, initially the ectoderm, which was differentiated into three layers, surface ectoderm, neural plate, and primitive streak. So therefore, please note down, the three germ layers in the embryo will develop only from cells of epiblast. So as a result of primitive streak and as a result of gastrulation, the three germ layers will develop from the cells of epiblast. Because initially the cells of epiblast, that is ectoderm, differentiated into three different layers. We started with that surface ectoderm, neural plate, and primitive streak. And these are the cells of primitive streak which are developing into this definitive endoderm, definitive ectoderm, and intraembryonic mesoderm. So therefore, this sentence is very important. All the three germ layers of the embryo will develop from epiblast cells itself. Right now, the last sentence will be, this is the development of trilaminar germ disc. And therefore, at this stage, as a result of gastrulation, there is development of the trilaminar germ disc. And now, here we end our primitive streak and gastrulation, but before ending, we need to write down this sentence. Therefore, this primitive streak and gastrulation, rather primitive streak, will serve as primary organizer for the development of the next stage. And what is the next stage that will come up? The next stage will be, after gastrulation, development of notochord. So primary streak will appear as primary organizer for the development of notochord. That is the next stage which is going to come up after this. And finally, in the end, there is one important diagram which is given in so many textbooks. According to the recent experiments, the primordial germ cells are believed to be developed from pluripotent ectodermal stem cells. That means the cells of the epiblast which differentiate into primitive streak. From those cells itself, the primordial germ cells have been developed. They have been differentiated. And later on, these primordial germ cells, after differentiating from epiblast, from the cells of primitive streak, they will then intermingle with the extraembryonic mesenchyme. As a result of their intermingling of extraembryonic mesenchyme, they will later on travel along with the allantoid canal into the primary yolk sac. This is according to the latest experiments, which is given in different textbooks. So here, we end our important short note of primitive streak or gastrulation. Thank you very much.